Welcome back, everyone. Another year, another time we get to talk about another set of these consoles. And what better console to kind of start off with than the Nintendo Switch? And what I can tell you is that the Nintendo Switch has been such an interesting console to me. And anytime I talk about it, I'm just so interested about, you know, this specific gaming console. We've had consoles like the, you know, Xbox Series S and X come out, the PlayStation 5 digital and disc models, but I still think about the Nintendo Switch because it just lives in its own lane. You know, most people I think out there own like something like a PlayStation and they own a Nintendo Switch, or they own a really good gaming PC and they own a Nintendo Switch. And Nintendo really has made their own lane in terms of the hybrid portable and, you know, in-home gaming console that you connect to a TV and all that. And I feel like the release of the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X and S, I thought by that time, most people would probably not want to buy Nintendo Switches, or maybe the Switches would be like some like back-end console. Maybe they don't care about it anymore. Their main priority was a PS5 or Xbox. But people are still selling out so many Nintendo Switches, and since the pandemic, since even the beginning, they've been sold out, and even now they're still sold out in so many places, it's insane. Now, I'm not gonna make this video about the history of Nintendo or what the Switch is, because everybody already knows those things, but I just kinda wanna talk about how it holds up right now, the updates that have happened, the games that have came out, everything like that, and just kind of describing if it's still even worth it. You know, obviously, it's completely worth it. It's still a great gaming console, but it's only been going up in value. It's not really easily attainable as it once was. I don't think it ever really was that attainable. So it may not be the best thing for people to go and just randomly spend a bunch of money or overpay for something like this if they know on the horizon maybe more Nintendo consoles are coming out and all that stuff, which I don't have any insider knowledge on, but it's still kind of interesting to look at. Now, first of all, the outside, I gotta bore you guys with the specs of this thing. The Nintendo Switch on the front, the standard one, has that 6.2-inch LCD panel on it. It's only a 720p panel, which is very interesting. A lot of the new leaks that are coming out for the Nintendo Switch 2 or the Switch Pro, whatever they're going to call it, it is saying that's going to get a higher resolution panel, potentially OLED, probably not OLED, but that'd be really, really cool if that had the capability. Now, you also have the Joy-Cons themselves, and I actually went and bought new Joy-Cons last year, and they're still holding up. They're not that durable. They're not that, you know, if you just get a little bit of dust and stuff inside of them, it can really affect what these specific Joy-Cons can do, but it's really not that bad, and I don't think Nintendo's gotten, you know, made them any better or anything, but I still think that for a majority of people out there, the Joy-Cons are really the best ways to go about, you know, playing the Switch. Obviously, there's other controllers. There's third-party Joy-Cons as well. I would kind of stay away from them. I would only stick with Nintendo Joy-Cons for the time being, and just keep sending them in. If you get problems with those Joy-Cons, keep sending them in. Throughout the year 2020, I was on that Switch subreddit a lot, and a lot of people, you know, suggested just keep hounding Nintendo and sending them in so they can kind of learn their lesson, and I would 100% recommend that. Now, on the bottom of the Nintendo Switch, you have that USB Type-C port, which is great. It supports Display Out. I'm pretty sure everyone already knows that. And on the back, you have that kickstand, microSD card slot, and all that good stuff. So that's really pretty much the outside of the Nintendo Switch. Not much has changed. There's not been a predecessor to the Nintendo Switch. We got the Switch Lite, but no other, you know, console like that. Now, with the Switch itself, what's something that's really, really interesting about it is that throughout last year, a lot of games came out, and we got that new Animal Crossing. Super Smash has gotten a lot of DLCs, and I think the gaming library of this thing has gotten much better, but I also think at the same time, the free games on the Nintendo Switch side hasn't really been that great. Obviously, we have things like Fortnite and that Kirby game and other things like that, but I really wish Nintendo really capitalized on the free game market, because, you know, if you look at mobile gaming, a lot of these games are free. They just have a bunch of downloadable things that you pay for, such as Fortnite and PUBG and even ad placements in games. Unfortunately, Nintendo, when I think of Nintendo Switch free games, I automatically think of like Fortnite or like Brawlhalla or something like that. I don't really think of anything super crazy. So I'm hoping in 2021, we do kind of see a huge movement in the free game market for Nintendo Switches, because like I said, a lot of people don't want to go and just keep, you know, buying a bunch of these games, and you look at mobile gaming and that's definitely taking over. So we'll see how it happens. We'll see how it goes, but that's definitely one market I really wish Nintendo were to go down. But a lot of these games and everything that have been coming out in 2020 are awesome, and it's almost leading me into being so excited about what the next generation of 2021 games will look like, because we have Nintendo Switch. Obviously, it's been a couple years in its infancy, and it's probably going to start ramping up here with production, especially with the Switch Pro or Switch 2 coming out at some point. But when you look at the other side of things with the Sony, you know, PlayStation 5 and the Microsoft Xbox, Nintendo's going to have to go and kind of make something and make some huge advancements with their next console and this console in terms of games, because like I said, even though most people end up having both a Nintendo Switch and a, you know, Xbox or Sony or whatever, there could be a shift very soon where some people are like, well, I can pretty much play those, you know, Sony games or my PS5 games or my, you know, Microsoft games on my phone with the remote play apps. You know, Microsoft and Sony have both built one for their designated consoles. So I kind of see, like I said before, mobile gaming, a lot of people like a portable gaming console. Well, why even buy a Nintendo Switch when you can play your games mobily on your device, even from your console itself? So I don't know what's going to happen. Maybe Nintendo will make some type of streaming thing for their Nintendo Switches as well. I guess we'll see. But that's going to be something that's going to be very interesting this year, because a lot of manufacturers, a lot of people are going to go ahead and switch to their mobile gaming platform. And with the Nintendo Switch, we'll just see what goes on with it. So this year, I'm really excited. I'm really looking forward to those specific games and, you know, everything coming out in that sense. Now, on the flip side, kind of talking more about the Nintendo Switch, what's very interesting is that I actually ended up modding my Nintendo Switch in 2020. Now, I didn't do anything crazy. I just went through the process. I didn't download anything. I didn't do anything crazy. I just literally modded it to see how the process was. And I'm going to take a few seconds just talking about it. And I'll tell you like this. It was such an interesting process, because I literally had to go and like, now, I had to first of all make a boot camp of Windows 10, because you can only do it on Windows. I ended up following the process. It took me about 3 days to do it correctly. And I had to make like some type of tinfoil thing, put it in the Joy-Con, and trick my Nintendo Switch into thinking I was like doing something else or something. It was so crazy. But at the end of it, I was able to actually go ahead and modify my Nintendo Switch and install custom firmware. And that was something that was very interesting. And I'll be honest, it was super fun. I was not expecting it for it to be fun. I've jailbroken a ton of phones. I've rooted and custom ROMed a lot of phones. But the last time I felt like this to a console was then when I had a Nintendo DSi, or I had a Nintendo DS, and I was trying to modify those consoles, even my 3DS. I tried to modify those and I did successfully do it. But that thrill of just, you know, getting that type of access on your device is so insane. And seeing that same thing on a Nintendo Switch, it was super crazy to me. So I was super glad I was able to do that. Again, I didn't do anything crazy, like I didn't download anything on it. Obviously you have to download apps and stuff to like get it working. I was able to install that, you know, shop and stuff, but it was very fun. So that was another pretty big improvement in terms of the overall access that I had on this device. Now, not all Nintendo Switches are, you know, utilized in that, but if you have a Nintendo Switch and it's capable, I would really recommend it. And I feel like support has only gotten up throughout last year. Now luckily the Nintendo Switch has gotten a couple updates last year. We now have the ability to go ahead and share screenshots and stuff. So that was another huge advancement in that standpoint. And I'll definitely tell you, the Nintendo Switch's battery life has also been pretty good. I don't know why. Like my Nintendo Switch, I don't play it that much. My Switch Lite is better though. But this Nintendo Switch's battery life is still actually pretty good in it. Honestly, I don't know if this is true or not. Maybe it has something with the Joy-Cons. The Joy-Cons I had before were so weird. I don't know what. There was always something wrong with them. In this case, I never really had any problems with the Joy-Cons, you know, because I got new ones. So I don't know if that ended up helping out the battery life or not. But the updates on the Nintendo Switch side were great. The battery life has also been, you know, maintaining pretty well. And I honestly, in this day and age in 2021, I just don't have any complaints about this console. I feel like most of the complaints I had are, you know, about the physical standpoint. I wish it did have a bigger battery. I wish it, you know, the screen was a little bit higher resolution. I kind of wish there was some more functionality with that USB Type-C port, with some like expandable storage or something like that. I'm not too sure, but I feel like those things would be cool. I understand it has a micro SD card slot, but maybe more capability with the USB Type-C port. But because of, you know, the advancement of mobile gaming, because of the newer consoles from the other side, the Microsoft and the Sony side, I'm really excited about what Nintendo is going to do this year. Because if you think about it, they're going to have to do something. I don't think, even though the Nintendo Switch is still selling like crazy, Nintendo doesn't really have any point into making another console right now. But at some point, they're going to have to do it. You know, they're going to have to do it, maybe not tomorrow, but maybe the next day. Obviously, I'm talking about years, but that would be something really cool to see when Nintendo's next step is. Are they going to go ahead and make the panel look better? Are they going to go ahead and increase the battery life? Are they going to go ahead and change up the UI completely and make something that we've never seen before? Are they going to make their own phone? You know, we used to hear rumors about that too. So we really don't know. But I'll definitely tell you one thing that I do know. The Nintendo Switch is still completely worth it in 2021. It's only going up in value in terms of a monetary sense and just the gaming sense. I mean, the games are getting better. The gaming library is increasing, which is awesome. We're seeing more games coming out. We're seeing more content coming out from the Nintendo Switches. We're getting a lot of modifications that we're going to be able to do very soon too. And the whole entire Nintendo Switch community is amazing, because there's just so many people that own one. And like I said before, I've never really had a device that's appreciated in value. I've had like iPhones and, you know, Androids and stuff, but this Nintendo Switch is the only thing that I can think of that's actually maintained its value and even gotten up, because I bought this thing back in, I think, 2018 or 2019. Sorry, I bought it in 2019 and I was like, cool. Like, I was just going to buy it and then expect to, you know, resell it for like $100 the next day. But it's like, I can still resell it for more than what I got it for, which is insane. So I think the Nintendo Switch is still worth it because it's an asset that can actually go up in value potentially. I don't know about that, you know, with my PlayStation 5 or my Xbox Series X or S. For now, I can still resell it and make more money, but I don't think, you know, 2 years from now it's still going to be, or 3 years from now, that's still going to be the case. So that really pretty much covers it up. I think the Nintendo Switch is still completely worth it in 2021. So if you guys have any other questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my other channels. More importantly, everything else. I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.